guys. We got cows today. I hope you enjoy the vlog, and we have a special bonus animal to show you at the end of the video. Here it comes. Hey there, folks. This is Josh, Stoney Ridge Farmer. Welcome back to the farm. It's another beautiful sunny day here in the foothills of the Blue Ridge Mountains of North Carolina. Today is a very special day for us. We went to the cattle auction yesterday up near Smith Mountain Lake in Virginia, and we bought two cows. We bought a cow-calf pair. So today, my stepdad is bringing the cow here to its permanent home, and we're going to release the cow into our new field, into our new pasture, where our new fences are, and we'll talk a little bit about what it's like to go to the cattle auction and buy a cow and what we're looking for in our cows so that we can maximize profitability and so that we have the best, healthiest cows possible. All right? Woo! Okay, so the first step in the process of putting cows in your pasture is making sure all of your gates are closed. So basically I kept all the gates open because deer come into the pasture and they kind of get, I don't want to say hung up, but they kind of get held up by the fence. So I wanted to make it easy for deer to pass in and out of the pasture. Now when we built this fence, we had Luke from Farm Fence Solutions here and a bunch of other guys, local guys, building the fence, and he said, man, I've never seen so many gates in a 1 mile stretch of fence. Well, we put a lot of gates in for specific reasons. Water sources are close by, and we fenced out our creeks. However, there's a little bit of game playing that we have to do in order to get a touch of reimbursement for our fences that fence out the creeks. In other words, we're protecting the watershed, and there are government programs to help us out with our fencing. We'll talk a lot more about that in future videos. So first, let's get our gates closed. I've got, I think, 3 or 4 gates open right here. Now, something to consider if you have cows or if you're thinking about getting cows or any kind of livestock is making sure that your gates that are accessible by public road are locked. Don't leave your gates unlocked. You have no excuse. Some prankster can come along, open that gate, and make for a very, very bad day for you or someone else. Now, there's a specific way we do everything on the farm for a specific reason. So here comes the gate latch. We're gonna throw that over. It's kind of hard to do this with a camera in my hand. We're gonna latch down into the gate. Okay, so this is fairly free. We don't want to leave this hanging. We want to actually tuck this up underneath that other rung right there. So if something lifts up on here, it actually pulls it down into the locking mechanism on the gate. And that way, if a horse learns, or a donkey learns, or a cow learns to lift this up and get out of the gate, well, he's only gonna raise it up and get himself out. These little nuances help when it comes to farming. Hopefully that right there will save you guys one day from having your animals accidentally get loose out into the road or something like that, and it's very, very dangerous. So I learned that from the Pro Fence guys. That's how you're supposed to close and latch a gate. If any of you guys have any comments or any other ideas, please post them down in the comments section. Now we're gonna head up to the other gate. I don't like driving on my fields when there's frost on the field. So when you run over the grass and there's frost on it, basically kills 2 stripes of grass. It stays like that sometimes all winter long, sometimes just a couple weeks, but I don't like to run over the grass when there's ice on it if I can possibly help it. So running through your fields is really not something that's too awfully advised. It kind of, well, it can stimulate the grass to grow, but in the wintertime it can stimulate the grass to freeze. Let's talk about this gate. This is a double gate that we put in between 2 pastures. Now, you don't see a pasture up there yet. We are building a first generation farm here, guys. So this is our first 2 cows on our first generation farm. And this whole hillside down here will be cleared off in the future videos. So we'll take that from what was forest, old scrubby forest, and we're gonna smooth it out, stump it, and plant grass and have more pasture established. That'll be about 25 acres, and there is the starts of a pond right here that I started building, I guess, early in the spring. Now we're gonna finish that pond up sometime, I guess, mid-year next year, but it's gonna raise the level all the way back into here, and we'll have a water source way up high. This is the highest point on the farm, so we can gravity feed water to the cows and keep them out of the creek. right, so we've got all the gates closed now, and we're gonna go down and wait on my stepdad. His name is Barry. He spent a lot of time with me, and he's got about 40 cows. He's been fooling with cows and raising cows and farming cows for probably 30 plus years. So he was my resource for going to these auctions, and he and I enjoy this kind of thing. So we rode out to a couple cattle auctions, and we got to see what different parts of the country had to offer. So while I got you here, let's do a little pasturology. So we just rode down past the land that we have behind our house, and it's about, I'm gonna say, close to 35 acres of fenced land behind our house. Now, eventually, we'll have a lane that comes out right up here at this gate. And this is where our dogs stay most of the time. There's a lane that comes out. That's a cool doghouse, by the way. we'll build a lane where the cows can be moved down here, and we're gonna be putting new fence up right here. And the new pond we just built, if you follow the vlog, is right there. So we're right here in the front yard of the house. So there'll be a pasture here, and this is approximately 3.5 acres, and then there'll be another one about an acre across the driveway, and we'll rotationally graze these cattle. For now, we're just putting two cows in a 30-something acre field, so there'll be plenty of forage out there, but we're building our herd, we're building our stock. Another thing we've got to do is we've got to get our waterers. We have two 100-gallon waterers, and for right now, with just these two cows, I don't really need to go crazy with the watering system. So we're gonna put one waterer down closer to the house, and we already have hoses and everything ran all the way up here behind the house. So we're gonna have two water locations. The cows will always have 200 gallons of water to drink from. That's waterer number one. And I'm putting it by the fence right here. I'm gonna basically zip tie a water hose. That way I can just turn it on, fill it up, turn it off. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take this gate, we're gonna put it up against the trailer on this side, and this gate up against the trailer on that side, and we'll release the cows.
Welcome home. Welcome home. All right.
All right, special bonus animal. I can't say how happy I am that we have cows now. We're gonna talk a little bit about why we purchased the cows that we purchased, and then we'll release the bonus animal.
Go ahead, donkey. Go ahead. There you go, fella.
We got ourselves a donkey. There goes the neighborhood. So the new cows and the Jenny donkey have been out here probably about an hour now. They're doing really well. I'm gonna turn the camera around. We'll zoom in on the cows and we'll talk a little bit about why we bought what we bought. Okay, so let's talk about the donkey. Why we bought the donkey. So this is a Jenny donkey. $100 is what we bought it for, and we bought it to help protect our calves from coyote and predator attack. Now, over here, look at our Angus heifer calf. And that calf is probably 3 weeks to a month old, something like that. Still on mom's milk, but eating grass. And this cow was a fairly large framed cow. It was the first cow to go through the auction in the cow-calf pair. So it was a very nice cow, but it kind of caught everyone off guard at the auction, and they were kind of feeling out the price. So we ended up getting a fairly good deal, $9.50 for the pair. After she went through, a lot of cows were in worse shape, brought up to $1,200 to $1,400 per cow-calf pair. So we got a pretty good deal on our cow. What we wanted was a full-bodied cow, meaning that she was healthy, she looked healthy, the calf looked healthy, and you can see she's just chowing down. She's got a nice full back end there, not a very bony cow, a pretty long cow, and a relatively strong-looking, beefy Angus cow. Now, when you're at a livestock auction, there are all manner of cows that go through. So they had the cows aged. In other words, this cow is a 7-year-old cow. They had them aged from 1 to 9, and then they had full mouth, broken mouth, and smooth mouth, meaning full mouth was over 9 to 10 years old, broken mouth was somewhere in between that, and then you have a smooth mouth cow, which means that their teeth are ground down. So basically the veterinarian ages the cow based on the wear of the cow's teeth. Pretty interesting. Some cows were marked pregnant, some cows were marked not pregnant. I don't think they preg checked this cow. In other words, this cow could be pregnant again, which would be awesome. Good stuff. Guys, I hope you learned a little bit today. I hope you are happy. We finally got our first cows here on the farm. I'm pretty excited. Glad to test this strong tornado wire fence out. Who knows where we go from here. So we're gonna go look at 2 more cow-calf pairs tomorrow, and we're gonna start stocking our farm up with our cattle. Hopefully we'll see you again here on the Stoney Ridge Farm. Please pound that like button, subscribe to the channel. This is just what's going on. We finally got our cows here on the farm. All right, woo!
Land of the free.